Hello guys, what's up? How are you doing? If you're new here, welcome to my stream. Happy Friday. And if you joined me last week, welcome back. We're going to finish our 3D scene in Adobe Dimension. I hope you can hear me fine and the music is good. I am listening to music by Harris Heller. If you want to listen to the same, there's a Spotify playlist down below in the description. And if you're tuning in, tell me how has your week been? Happy Friday again. And there are some goodies like free links where you can get 3D materials and 3D objects from for free. You can check it out in the bio, and let's switch to the work area. So if you tuned in last week, this is how the scene looked like. So it was not like this last week. I did a lot of changes. And we're just gonna dive in. Before that, let's just say hello. Hi, Excellence. Hi, Ron. Hi, Derek. Hi, Albert. Wow, I'm so glad. All right, I will just lower the music. Is it better now? I'm not sure. Let me check again. Let me know in the chat if it's good. There's a lag between the stream and the chat, so I'm not really sure if the music's fine. How about now? I hope it's fine now. So let's get started, guys. This is the scene. So as you can see, I made some changes. So this olive branch, for instance, this was like an Adobe stock asset. And these blueberries as well are like from Adobe stock. This is also from Adobe stock. This is a star anise that I added. And then these are the wine glasses. I'll just zoom in a little. So we have these wine glasses with some wine in it. This time I did not forget. And there is a wine bottle with a cork, and there is a carpet, there is butter and stuff like that. So, oh, and by the way, I wanted to make bread as well, because what good is a wine and cheese board without bread, right? So, yeah, I added some wine and also some bread. This bread is, I think, from turbosquid.com. If you want, I can leave it later in the chat. But I think I heard Paul Trani mention it in one of his live streams before. So yeah, turbosquid.com is where you can get free 3D objects. So that's where you can find something like this. And before we get started, I just want to show all of these renders that I did. So I did like various angles. So this one is like one from a left-hand perspective. There is one from top. So I think the beauty of creating something in Adobe Dimension is that it's like having these 3D objects in real life, and you can literally take photographs from all different angles. So in Adobe Dimension, you can also put perspective and focus points, but I really haven't done that yet because I was still in the experimental phase, and these are just the initial renders. So yeah, these are some of the few renders that I had, and it's terrible how much time renders take. I mean, if there are any 3D artists in the chat, they know how terrible it is to render 3D stuff. I know Derek is a 3D artist, so he can probably tell you. Alright, so if you know me, you know like I like custom textures and custom objects. So I decided to create textures of my own, and I did not know how to create them in Illustrator or Photoshop, so I decided to make them in Adobe Capture. So if you don't know, and if you haven't used this before, Adobe Capture is also one of the apps from the Adobe Creative Suite. I used it on my iPad, and I decided to make a video out of it. So, since I couldn't connect my iPad on here while streaming, I just decided to show you in the form of a video how it's gonna look like. So, this is the video. I'm just gonna play it right here, and it's basically gonna tell you how I capture an image and convert it to a texture that I can apply directly to an object in Adobe Dimension. So, this is how it goes. As you can see, these are all the textures that I already have. I click on click a photo. You can tap to freeze it. This texture has like a rough thing to it. And we go on the screen, it gives you like this material over here. Then you can adjust the roughness details, make it metallic if you want, increase the intensity if you want the fabric to come out of it and make it look like. And down below you can see there are different shapes that you can check in, so how your texture is going to look like on different shapes, you can check that as well. And a shopping bag too. So this is how quickly and easily I created this in 1 minute. This video is unedited and it's super simple. So if you ever struggle finding 3D textures or 3D materials, you can go to Adobe Capture and do this Oh, hey Sean, hey Fergie, glad to see you guys here, and I will decrease the music. I hope it is better now. Yeah, I found out that the music was really too loud. Okay, awesome. It's just that when you switch screens, OBS is really definitely giving me a hard time. But I am so glad Sean could join us. Sean is a wonderful streamer. We have a streamer in the chat. It is awesome to have you, Sean. And we also have Fergie who's going to stream, so that's great. And anyone who is new and is joining in, you can see my info below, I think, over there. Yeah, so there is Twitter, there is YouTube, there is Behance, there is Instagram, and also my website. So if you want to check it out, do let me know, reach out, give me a shout if you need some help. I'm also new here and we're all learning. So yeah, all right, let's continue. So like I mentioned, I just captured those with Adobe Capture. So I did like butter, just things lying around the house. So I did butter, I did some crackers as well. And I think I also did one more, but I'm really forgetting what it was. So let's just dive in. Let's see my capture textures. Awesome, I'm glad the music's good now. Great. So this is my biscuit or the cracker texture. This is my butter. So while I was experimenting, this butter texture was really, it was really smooth because it was my first time making a texture in Adobe Capture. And I'm like, hey, what is this? I haven't used this. Used something like this before. But let's go ahead and unlock these. If you've seen, I've already renamed all my layers. I like my things clean and organized. So yeah, there you go. And I would also recommend it because when you have so many objects in Adobe Dimension, it gets really hard to find your objects later on. So yeah, this is like in code, you have to rename and put comments on everything. It's just like that. So yeah, I'm just gonna quickly unlock all of these. Meanwhile, how is your week, guys? What have you guys been up to? And are you excited for the weekend? What have you got going on for the weekend? Okay, while you answer that, because there is a lag, I will go ahead and add the butter texture. So what I do is simply select the object that you want to add the texture to, and you just click on the texture, and it's applied. There you go. And over here, you can manipulate it as well. So as you can see in the navigation panel over here, there is a base color and the repeat as well. So I see some light which is like too much, it's very high saturation. No, wait, it's not saturation. I'm sorry, I'm not a photographer. Sean, don't kill me, please. And yeah, I'm just gonna decrease it so it's like a little bit, you know, softer to the eye, soothing to the eye. Yeah, so this is how the butter looks like. All I did was click on this, click on the material, go to the navigation bar, which is over here. You click on the properties. You can increase or decrease this repeat. So let's say I make this 30. Let's see what will happen. This gets this funky looking texture over here. Let me just zoom in a little. I press 2 on the keyboard to do this, by the way. So I'm just panning across like a camera would do. I press 1 to orbit around the object. And look what we have here. So I repeated the texture for like 30 times. And it's given me this funky looking butter. Let's render it and see how it looks. Oh, hey, Gonzalo, how are you? Thank you for joining us. I'm so glad you could make it after your philosophy test. Okay. Yeah, this butter looks really wonky, to be honest. So I'm just going to go ahead, go back to my butter. Where is my butter? Make it, I think 0.7 was like good. Yeah. Obviously, it's not going to be perfect, guys, because it is Adobe Dimension, which I can't sculpt in here. Although I do love Adobe Dimension, but this is not Blender, right? So I can't really manipulate all the vertices for all the 3D artists out there judging me. But I do plan to make these objects from scratch, and I have like something good in store for you later on. I'm working on something to implement. So all right, we have our butter already and we're just getting started. So let's see what we have here. I remember Fergie mentioned she really likes crackers and cheese and all of that. Oh, by the way, Fergie and Sean and Gonzalo were just joining in. I also mentioned like earlier, there are 3D models and 3D materials available. Links are in the bio. So if you want to check it out, you guys can check it out. You can get all kinds of 3D textures you want. But for the sake of the live stream, I have found all these textures already. So I'm going to be using them. Let's just go with, I think this is a cheese. So I went on to wecteasy.com, and Wecteasy has this beautiful, they have all file versions. So you have .ai, .eps, .svg. If you want to include it in your website, you have a blue cheese. I don't know why, but well, if you want, you have it. And there is also license information. So of course, since it's Creative Commons license, you have to give them credit for it. But over here, I'm just going to use a JPG file. So I go back to my dimension scene and also save your work, guys. So Control S or Command S for the Mac. We have the cheese over here, which is just a slice. I zoom in just by scrolling my mouse. This is the cheese. I drag and drop it on the cheese directly. That's how simple it is. And if you can see closely, this looks so weird. Like, what is this? Is not what I wanted, right? Press V on the keyboard again, and here's the graphic. You see over here, there's a placement. And it's either a decal or a fill. So in situations where you're doing packaging design, that's where you use a decal. And actually, you might as well use fill on that if you're using a different kind of packaging, if it's not a sticker that you stick onto a packaging like this on top. So over here, fill is gonna change the whole look of it, and this is how it looks. So this surface, since it was made in Photoshop and there were some imperfections while I was doing it, this is only applied on top. Now, how do I apply it on the sides? As simple as dragging and dropping again. And the same thing all over again, go to properties, go to fill. But this time it's applied on both the sides. And how good is this, right? I mean, did you even think it would be this simple to make blue cheese in Adobe Dimension? I for one didn't. Let's see what's going on in the chat really quickly. There are some people joining in. Thank you for joining in. You're welcome, Fergie, you know it. Hey Albert, thanks for joining in. I'm definitely using blue cheese on my website, Gonzalo says. Yes, definitely. I know you were making your website, so an SVG file. I can send it to you, don't worry. So let's go back to not rendering it. We don't want the stream to hang, right? That's the last thing we want. I actually want the stream to go on really quickly and smoothly, because last time 2 hours were a bit too much. Anyway, so we have blue cheese and butter. And now I'm going to add the crackers again because I have it right here. So you click on the crackers, you click on the biscuit texture that you created in Adobe Capture. You click on that. And since this is a group, all of these, I place them. Oh, I'm sorry. This is why I lock my objects, guys. I place them in such a way that they look like they look realistic. And then I group them, and it was super easy to just, you know, they look so realistic. Let me just render it real quick and show you. Hey Elsa, thank you for joining us. I'm so glad all you guys join in. I'm forgetting, Elsa, where are you from again? What part of the world are you joining in from? We have the crackers. I'm so excited about all this. I'm quickly gonna unrender it and show you the rest. So if you've explored or dabbled in 3D dimension, Adobe Dimension or 3D Dimension. Wow. If you've... I surprise myself every day with my typos and my speech. But if you have dabbled in Adobe Dimension before, you know there are like starter assets over here. There are multiple starter assets. There are more than enough for you to get started. If not, you can go to stock.adobe.com and you can select 3D from the category. So you can select 3D and you can write in what you want. It will filter out. There are paid as well as free objects that you can license, paid objects that you can license and free objects that you can just save to your cloud. And this is how you filter it with models over here in Adobe Dimension. This is materials. This is the lighting, which we'll get onto later on. And these are the images that you can use as background. Not that you can't use custom images from the internet. You can do that, definitely. But there are some inbuilt images as well, part of the starter assets, right? So I wanted to create some lamps for my scene, and these were all made in Illustrator. If you guys want, I can give like an overview again for someone who did not join last week. If you want that, let me know in the chat and I can do it. But you may be wondering, there's no light in it, right? This is just glass. How am I going to put in light? So what I did was I took a sphere. Okay, I'm just going to turn it on. And I see immediately that it's not centered. So I took spheres. One sec, let me just center this a little. my OCD is being triggered. And yeah, I think this is good now. And I'll center this as well. The maximum ability that I can do with eye. I can definitely use the align button in the navigation. So I just select these two objects. Click and drag. And then you see this align toolbar being activated. So you can change any of this in whatever direction you want, right? I can do that as well, but I sometimes like to go in and change things manually. Just like in Illustrator, it's fine to move things manually when they don't look right even after aligning. So that's just something that I did over here. So how did I create these lights, right? I did not show this last time, so I'm just going to quickly create another sphere. I click on the sphere, I just dragged and dropped the starter asset. I clicked on the materials, and right below the glass, there is a glowing material, right? You wonder what that is? That can be used as a light. So we have already clicked the object. We clicked the glowing.mdl, and oh, it should have applied. My bad. So you just drag and drop it, and there you go. It looked like a 2D object now, but it's really not. It is a 3D object, which will glow. So if I render it out, if I see like a render preview, I'm not really rendering right now. It's just a quick preview to see how things are going to look like after rendering. And you're just going to have a better idea about things are right where you are. Because sometimes some colors don't come out right and you need to check how it's going to look in some like a particular lighting. And for that purpose, this is like really quick, because sometimes if the file size is really big and there are too many objects, it takes too long for things to render, right? So yeah, anyway, this is the glowing object. I'm going to delete that. Let's delete this. Let's save this and see what's happening in the chat. I'm amazed by those crackers. Thanks, Fergie. Elsa is joining us from Tanzania. Can't wait to see the final render for this. Oh yes, me too. Thanks. I'm glad you're excited. So I'm zooming out. Hey, Kayo, how are you doing? Anyway, let's do this quickly, right? So I have this cutting board right here. And like I mentioned, I got some textures. So I think I should have this right over here. I think it's this. Yeah. So I have this really nice looking, very clean wood texture. Again, just drag and drop, guys. That's how simple it is. Like, Dimension has literally made my life so easy. You can get started super quick. And this is like a starter pack into Dimension. Anyway, so this is, I think I want to rotate this a little because this is too dense for a cutting board. Let's just see what happens, right? You just need to like see what happens, experiment with a little. I think this should be fine, right? What do you guys think? Should I decrease it? Should I increase it? Let's leave it at that for now. So let's move on to the bread. You know what the trick is? The bread literally changed the game. I'm literally gonna go to the bread. I think this is it. So over here, that like if you see, I think Fergie is familiar with UVs, and UVs are basically a 2D representation of a 3D object. So you can change that in Photoshop. You can make your own UVs in Illustrator or whatever software you want, even Fresco or anything, Procreate, anything like that, whatever you're comfortable with. And I found these UVs for this exact same object, and it was so beautiful. So I'm just going to click on this object. I'm going to drag and drop it onto the bread. And okay, you were not amazed. But behold, you're going to be amazed. What's up with that? There is a bread right here. It's obviously not French bread, but it's something. It's better than nothing, right? So there is our bread. I'm going to render, preview it. How do you guys like your bread? Let us see. I don't know. Oh, I did not click on the button. I'm sorry. My bad again. So it's wrenching out. My laptop is making noises, but that's just the fan. Don't worry. All right. So I'll render out really quickly. And guys, if I'm going really quickly, just let me know. I can like slow down a little, but I really didn't want to waste any time. That's why this is like super quick. So like you can see, these are the grapes. I'm going to rotate it a little, orbit around the object, zoom in a little, press 3 on the keyboard and zoom it. I'm sorry, I don't have the tool timeline working yet, but I will next week. Don't worry about that. So I don't have to tell you what the shortcuts are that I'm pressing. But yeah, these are the grapes. I think I already have a matte texture on top. I'll just go and check. No, I don't. So I'll click on this group. This is an object. I created the stem in Photoshop and Illustrator, sketched in Illustrator, and then made a 3D extrusion in Photoshop. And I just made a group out of this. So I'm quickly gonna add matte to it because I don't want my grapes to look metallic, right? That's the last thing I want. So I go to sphere. I think I did use grapes before. I'm just gonna find the right color for it. If I don't think I have it, but I'm just gonna check. These are some of the objects that I used earlier, but yeah, I don't think I have it. Let's just quickly go and add like a purple. So I go to the sphere, I go to the base color, I go to, let's say, this color. Okay, let's do one sec, hold on. Maybe a little bit darker, right? How about now? Let's render and see how it's gonna look in the environment that we have selected already. I thought it was harder to add textures. LOL, Albert. Yeah, it is harder when you actually make those textures yourself, but I just got this off the internet. So it's not hard when you're just like getting Creative Commons images. It is hard. Ask Fergie how hard it is to create your own textures. I actually wanted to create my own textures, but it's a little too hard to do on a live stream, so I decided against it. Let's see. Let's render it out and see how it looks again. Ooh, this is a very funky looking purple color. Have you seen these like this colored purple before? Hold on, these look like they're artificial. We don't want that. Let us get the sphere. Let's move it a little towards red, guys. I think that could look a little better. Oh yeah, I like this color. Now, as you can see, the stem is also the same color, and we don't want that, but it happened only because this was a group. So we go to stem. You can see in the actions button there are two buttons. This is for placing the graphic, which we don't want. We don't want to place a graphic on grapes. And this is like the link material. So this is a linked object to all the spheres. If I click on this, it's now an unlinked object, and I can change the color or the material right here. So I think I did these grapes before. And I am trying to make it like a metal, right? I don't know why I just like grapes with metal on top. Metal grapes top, like I like to call it. Anyway, so let's see how it looks. I'm also quickly gonna save it because I know how it feels when your file gets corrupt and you lose all your progress. Excellence knows what I'm talking about. Okay, these kind of look very dark. Hold on a second. Let me fix this really quickly. And then I'll move on to the chat. I know there are a few messages, but I'll just come back. So I go to sphere again. Oh, hold on. I swear I was gonna cuss right now, but I realize I'm on a live. And last time I said something and I regretted it. I'm like, oh shit, I shouldn't have. But I'm super careful. This morning I think someone was streaming and they asked Ryan if how many cuss words, like, can you cuss in a stream? And they're like, think of it like a professional interview. Like, would you cuss there? And they were like, yeah, I probably wouldn't. And so that's how you stream. So I'm like putting myself in the zone. Like, you guys are my interviewers. Okay, this looks like a little bit more realistic. So, like you can see, guys, it's all a little bit of playing with colors over here. And like I said, you have to see the render preview sometimes to see how the color is going to look in the current environment that you set. Obviously, if you change the light, it is going to impact how the objects are looking. But just to get started, I think we're okay with that. We're going to adjust it later on, how we compared, like in comparison to how we feel, right? I'm going to zoom out here a little. I'm going to rotate this. Can you see, guys? It's already coming to shape. I really love how these contrasts are looking with the wood and the grapes. So these are some olives that I also created in Illustrator and Photoshop. And quickly, let's just go to the chat. Albert, Fergie, UVs. Yes, what were those purple or white images for? They were just like color. I'm not sure. Hold on, let me see. So these were just like blending modes. You can change it anywhere. These are just already available. And you can also, if you can see over here, I think it must have it. It doesn't. It's just for like object mapping. to those 3D objects, like 2D images, to object map it correctly. I don't think we need it though. If you just put like a JPG, it'll work. So here is my olive. I think I'm gonna make like green olives, and these are pitted olives. So you can see, like, I initially wanted to create like a toothpick or a skewer in between, but I decided against it because it was so much effort to make a toothpick. Okay, there is no material on here. So again, I'm gonna go to matte. I'm going to apply matte. These two are matte now. I click on the material. I am gonna go to greens, maybe like a green, moving towards yellow. Hey Anika, it feels so nice to watch a stream at 6:30 PM IST. Thanks Mayura, I know, right? All the streams start at like, so we guys are based out of India. I guess Mayura is also in India, and every stream starts at like 9:30 PM over here, and they go on until 5. And few of my favorite streamers actually stream at 5:30 AM or 6 AM, and I'm like, wait, am I not supposed to sleep the whole night or like wake up that early? But yeah, I'm glad you could join in, Mayur. I'm glad you're here. Albert says he's going to leave the stream. I have an interview in 5 minutes. Good luck for the interview, Albert. Thank you for joining. I'm glad you could be here. And Fergie says good luck. Okay, so we have... I was talking, didn't even realize that the olive was like too dark. So we have the olive right here. I'm going to change the color a little bit. I think this should be here. Oh, it was nice, Fergie. I just changed it, I'm sorry. I think this is what happens when there's like a lag, but I still have it here. So the application actually remembers the colors that you chose earlier. So I'm gonna select one as the older one, make it the older color, and one, the next one to be like the new one, and see and compare how it's gonna look. Let us see. And I'm also gonna increase the opacity, roughness. So they look a bit more real. What's happening to me, guys? What is up? Okay, I frankly like this one more, so we're gonna go with the first one. You were right, Fergie. The first olive color looks great. So let us go to the first olive color, save these, and zoom out, and actually go. So over here are camera bookmarks that I already selected, and this is my home. And these are a few camera perspectives that are selected. These are similar to, like, these are the things that are rendered out for you already. So this is what I have. This is from the top. And look at it, guys. I mean, I'm so glad this is already taking shape. I press Command S again. Tongue tied with words. Huh, I get that all the time too. I know, right? I know. It's been happening to me since, like, I started streaming today. I don't know what's happening. I'm not even nervous today. I mean, a little, but not as much as I was the first time. Yeah, I'm definitely not nervous. Okay, so we have this wine bottle, and I think Derek mentioned it that he likes red wine last time. So I'm gonna make this red wine. It's like, I don't know. I don't like red wine, but it's okay. Let's just make red wine. This is already glass, but if it's not, I'll just select glass. Yeah, it's glass. So wait, hold on. Where did the bottle go? I'm quickly also going to log the grapes and the things that I've already done, right? So the serving place was also like an Adobe stock asset, so I just did not do anything with that. There is splash, that is definitely not something I created. There's olive branch, that is also an Adobe stock. There is knife, and again a spill, that is also, okay, I don't want to log that. There's butter that I created, so that's a good thing. There's carpet that I got from, I don't know where, but like one of the websites that I mentioned. And the wine inside crackers I've already done. Spoon is also Adobe stock. We have to go to wine bottle. Red wine is the best. I don't know. I think red wine is too spicy for me. I think only perfumes should be spicy, right? Not wines. Or maybe I haven't tried wine, red wine enough, to be exact. Okay. Let's just make this wine bottle. Okay, I think I'm happy with that color. It looks so bare without a label. Okay, let's just jump in and quickly change the wine color as well. So let's just go to the wine color. So like you can see, guys, it is already becoming so difficult for me to find objects over here. And I've actually named the objects, and it's still difficult for me to find. Imagine what would have happened if I would have wouldn't have named it. Okay, there you go. There's wine inside. If I delete, if I press the eye icon, it can show or unshow. Hide, not unshow. Wow. Fergie, I need help today. This is the wine. I don't know, maybe like this color, if it's gonna show. Let's see how it's gonna look like rendered out. Let's click on this button. Let's see the render preview. It's gonna be too light, I think. But since the bottle color is too dark, it's not gonna look so bad. And it's definitely taking some time to render because there's a lot of objects now. And I hope you guys can still hear the music. Last time there was some issue with the music and just stopped in between, right? Let's see what's happening. I prefer red too, Derek. Fergie says she prefers red too. If we guys ever meet, I'm getting my own white wine. Where is this again? There's wine inside. Okay, awesome. Let's change that color to be a little bit darker, right? I think this should be good. I can also see that it's probably not straight. I will also change that. Cutting board is done. Splash is done. Wine inside. Press V on the keyboard and rotate it a little. Push it back a little. Yep, I think it should be fine. I'll just orbit around to see how it's looking. I think it's fine. That's just the light. This thing that you see, it's just the light. It's not the object that's outside. So anyway, this is done. Now there's one thing that's missing, that is the top. And we go back to my free textures, my saviors. And I will see, okay, I had this really nice image. Again, I don't remember what out of those few links that I mentioned are. Which one is it? But this is definitely so helpful. It's gonna make it look really realistic. Also, I forgot I had to make the roughness a little higher on these orders. But yeah, look at this, guys. Like, so beautiful. Even with the decal version of it. I mean, what is this? Okay, I'm sorry. I not select it. What is happening? Where is my cork? Right here. We have, okay, I'm sorry, I was selecting the wrong thing. We will place it as a fill. And we will also increase the roughness to be the maximum, because if you've ever had wine with a cork on top, you know how it is, right? So I'm gonna zoom in a little again and see, rotate all around it. Looks so beautiful. Anyway, I feel like having wine now. We have wine. There is olives, and I will quickly unlock this since we're doing it. I'm gonna go to pass. The roughness is already max. Okay, I'm gonna let it be then. All right, wine inside is done. The butter is done. The copper is not done. The cutting board is done. The olives are done. Cool. Elsa also loves red wine. Music is good. Thanks, Fergie. I'm glad you like it. It is very chill, lo-fi music. I've been trying to like work with this music for so long. And yeah, let's see what else is happening. There is Elsa also loves red wine. Which white wine do you like? I like Chilean Chardonnays. They're good. Chilean wine in general is very good. I prefer that. Sparkling white. Oh yeah, sparkling white is good too. I like sparkling wine. Definitely. There is. Okay. So what do we have left? We have this lace. I did find, I did create a texture in Adobe Capture for lace. But since it was not really a PNG. As they say, it had a black background on top. So I'm just going to select it and see how it's going to look. I don't think it's going to look so good. Wait, this is also something that I created. But it's definitely not looking like something I want. So let's select this one. Nope, I'm just gonna select like a starter asset material. Let's say a fabric. I don't know if there is a fabric on here. Is there a cloth material out here? Let's see. I don't think so. Let's just search cloth, fabric, striped fabric, or let's say weave fabric. Ooh, this is so cool. I did not know there was a weave fabric out here. Okay, let's just select this and change the color. So I'm gonna select like a white. Maybe not completely white. Do you think this is on the ground? I don't think so. Let me see. Oh, definitely not. Way, way. Yep. Okay, awesome. Oh, I see why I did that. But we're gonna edit that later on. I don't think I'm gonna use the carpet anyway because I'm gonna create like a night light because this is a very dinner and an intimate setting. So I just don't want to create like a daylight scene, right? This is gonna be a night light scene. And hence the whole glowing object right here. So I think we're only left with the wine and also these lamps. So I'm quickly gonna go to lamps. Again, if I'm going really quickly, please tell me, let me know in the chat and I can go a little slower. I just realized it's just been half an hour. I'm like going like a train. So this is, wow, this looks good, guys. What do you think? This is like a vitreous glass effect, and I really love this effect. And you can see it already is taking shape, and I really like how colors interact with each other. Like there are some light tones over here, and they're interacting beautifully with like the wine bottle and the wine, the lamp and the grapes. And it's amazing. Like these neutral tones over here with the bread and the butter and the cutting board and these colors, like boom in your face. Let's render this really quickly and see how it looks. Oh wow, do you guys like this glowing sphere in the lamp? Also, wherever you guys are watching from, it'll be great if you can click the appreciate button. It's gonna help me a lot. And also share my stream if you like. You can also watch the replay if you missed anything. And yeah, feel free to check my stuff out. All my social media information is right down below. So you can check it out. And let me know what you think. So I think we have the lamps. I still haven't gotten anything on how you like the lamps, but I'm gonna move on and wait. Okay, we're gonna do the wine glasses as well. So let's just, I think this is already a glass texture, but I'm quickly gonna check. Yeah, this is glass. I'm just gonna change the color a little bit. Maybe like a, oh, okay, not this color. Maybe like a pale yellow color. Just a little bit. Just to give that a little tinge on top and not have like a white glass. And it's so beautiful since my colors are saved. And my history is saved. I can just select this and see how it's gonna look. Hold on, there's the last one. And yep, there you go. Fergie says, what if the globe is a warm white? Yes, we are getting to that. We are gonna change that, definitely. We haven't touched the glowing sphere yet. But I'm definitely gonna ch change the color because I'm gonna change the color of the environment as well. So that is a very good suggestion, Fergie. Thanks for the suggestion. Let's get on to the light also really quickly. Let's just change the splash. So we have the splash. This was again from the Adobe Starter Assets. So I think over here, I'm just gonna search it, SPL. There's three kinds of splashes, A, B, and C. You can choose any that serve your purpose. The splash material is already there, and I already have the wine. Oh my god, this is looking too red. Yeah, I think this is cool. This is better than the red that we had. Okay. Yeah. And this thing, I think, has wine. This is just an object that I again created in Photoshop. So let's just go and click like select liquid right here. I don't know. Where is liquid? There's water. Yeah. This is exactly what happened to me last time. I just wanted to select liquid and there was no liquid. There's just water out here. They don't want us drinking wine. What just happened? Oh, I selected the liquid and did not color it. Was that it? That's not what happened. Something went wrong. Hey. Let's see what happened. Where is you already changed this? We change this. Let us see where the poured wine is. What did I do? I don't know why this is happening. This is so weird. I think I did not, I forgot to delete the materials off of it in Photoshop. That's why this is happening. So we're gonna go back and change it. Let me just quickly change this color as well and see what happens. Okay, that is so weird. But I'm gonna change all the colors. Let's see what happens. I don't wanna waste time going, okay. Okay, extrusion material. Yeah, it's because I did not remove the texture and the color from Photoshop, and that's why it's not applying color. So remember guys, whenever you're using Photoshop and you're making images, 3D objects from scratch, remember to remove the textures and color and like all the shadows from it, because this is what will happen if you don't. Okay, so we saw that little hiccup and here we are. I'm going to check in on the chat really quickly. Hey Koala, I'm glad you could join in. How are you doing today? Koala made it. And I just saw your Insta story. Oh, Fergie put it on her Instagram. That is awesome. Thanks. Thanks, Fergie. Fergie says, LOL, you know, I was bad at the lighting last time, so I need to pay attention to that. Oh, definitely. That's how strategically plays lighting at like second half of the stream, because like I want people to stay tuned. Fergie tips for a live stream. This is what I've been learning from all the live streamers out there. I don't know if Sean's still here, but yeah, he's also a very good teacher. I love his streams. So I think there we have it. We have every object. I can't see if we've missed anything. I'm probably gonna remove the carpet. Let's just see if I quickly added. There is a fabric thing, but I'm not even sure if this is like a canvas. I don't want to include that. And I did have like a floor. So let's lock the lamps. Let's lock the star anise. Let's lock the blueberries. Let's lock the wine glasses as well. And everything that we've already done. Now becomes our environment, right? So I've already created these walls. I'm zooming out a lot. And here are my walls. I want like a very neutral color for these walls. I just go to the wall. I click on my starter assets. Click on matte. I click on matte. Repeat the process. It's like if you get one right, you get all right. You click on the matte. Texture, you click on this base color. I'm just gonna choose like a very neutral pastel color over here, like a pastel pink. I really like pastels, can you tell? And yeah, wall behind. Yeah, Derek, I know, right? Me too. Okay, we have a pastel colored scene right here. Let's just quickly go to the home. Okay, this doesn't show any walls. Okay, press B on the keyboard, save it. We don't want everything to die. Click on render preview and see how the scene looks. I really like how this is taking shape, guys. What do you think of the scene, guys? Let me know in the chat. What do you think? Yeah, I'm gonna quickly go back and yeah, let's zoom out a little. I don't think I want the fabric, so I'm just gonna hide that. Where is the carpet? I don't know, I have to find it. Hide the carpet and like move everything. I think this is gonna be cool. Let's zoom in a little to see everything is placed on the ground. Press 1, orbit around it, and this is definitely not on the ground. So we'll place that later on. It's going to take a lot of time locking and unlocking everything. So I'm just going to leave it like this for right now. Edit that later. That's super easy. You can do it very easily. I don't know what this is. Oh, this is the bread. I forgot to name it. I'm quickly going to name it. Okay, there's a floor as well. So for the floor, we have this plane. Since this is not going to be interactive, I can just do whatever. I don't mind this coming out of the whole environment. So this is the floor. I selected a few of the marble textures. I think this is again from one of the links. I think textures.com is where I got it. And I'm just going to select the, I'm sorry, I'm in the fabric. Let's go to textures. This is one of the textures. That's one, marble one. That is marble two. I think I'm gonna choose marble 006. Okay, let's just drag and drop it. Okay, so when you get this kind of an error, it's basically when you want to convert your object, it's been modified in Adobe Dimension. So what you do, you click on this, and there's this new little thing that popped up in your actions pane, and it says convert to a standard model, freeze the properties of parametric, and convert it to a standard model. So if you want to make any changes such as the width or anything else, you can just do that and click on standard. I just convert that so I can add a marble texture on top. I did that, and as you can see, again, it's like a decal by default, and it's too much. It's too much. It's too much. Let's repeat this. Okay, that's okay. Probably a little too much, but I think I should rotate it. Let's zoom out. Zoom out. Rotate it like this. I don't want any activity around my objects because I want that to be just about the objects. And this is too much, guys. I don't want this. I think I'm gonna go with the plain floor. This is too much activity. Fergie says, looks great, like a romantic picnic. Oh yeah, that's what I was going for. And then Derek says, it was romantic to someone spill the wine. Absolutely, yeah, that's exactly what happened. Let's just remove this graphic. I really don't like this. Hopefully not on a white shirt or dress. Oh wait, that always happens. We know the pain. And then you have to do like all this drama to get the wine out. Floor should be grass. I actually thought of that, and I don't think it's gonna look good with walls around it. And the walls of a sunset in Paris. That's a good idea, actually. I do have a few paintings. Let me just show you real quick. Maybe I'll add a painting instead of this, just because you gave me that idea. So I'm just gonna add. I think I got this off Adobe Stock or somewhere else. I think Adobe Stock was it. Got a few things. I have flowers as well over here, so I didn't need anything. I think I can add some flowers as well. But do sunflowers go with wine? I don't know. I really don't know. Let us see where the paintings were. They're not here for sure. Let us check it out. They must be here somewhere. New group. Where are you? Oh, here it is. Let us see what the painting looks like. Where is the painting? It's too small. Oops. We want to lock the floor. Let's just go. Okay, that is what's happening. Can you see this? Fergie, take a look. Take a look, Fergie. This is one of the few paintings I got from stock.adobe.com. Again, brilliant stuff. But this is definitely not gonna show because this is not on the table, so I'm gonna delete that. All right. Let us quickly now dim the light. Since we're creating like an evening scene, let us zoom out and see how it looks. So, do you remember, guys, how I showed you like this glowing sphere? I'm gonna do the same out here for the lighting. So, instead of it just being like a small light, I'm gonna create a bigger light out of it. So, I think I should lock everything first because if something goes wrong, I don't want everything to go haywire. I control save, command save for me, but control save if you're working on a PC. I click on the sphere. We have this small little sphere out here. Actually, you know what? I'm gonna use a cylinder. I click on this cylinder. Again, small little cylinder because we zoomed out, too zoomed out, and the walls are too big for the scene, but I just wanted everything to include. We click S on the keyboard to scale it down a little, just one dimension. Press V again, and I just want to rotate it to 90 degrees on the x-axis. So I'm rotating it, and don't worry if you do it till 93. Over here, you can see the rotation. You can type in what you want as well. And it's gone under the ground. So this is what you do to fix that. I'm just going to put this element right here and create light. I'm quickly going to put glowing material on top of this and create like a yellowish color, like a warm white, like Fergie said. I don't know if this did the trick. We just have to experiment again. Oh, I think this is too bright, but we're only gonna know until we have like the environment light turned off. So we're gonna quickly copy paste it to have like more light around the objects. So I'm gonna quickly rotate it to get light from top. I think this is too small, maybe. So I'm gonna increase this a little. Yeah, these are our two light sources. I think I want to add a third one. Let's just copy paste just in case. So Command C, Control, Command V. And we just rotate this a little. Move this out here. Rotate this a little more. And I'm gonna zoom in and change this ways light as well. So we have these spheres. Press V on the keyboard. We have these spheres, the lamps. We have this color. I think it changed it. I can't really see because it's too bright outside the environment. So let us go to lamp light small. We have this. Okay. I forgot to change the color of the floor, so I'm not gonna apply any material on top of the floor because it's getting too much. Like, I don't know how people spot pattern with pattern. I'm really not one of those people, and I really don't know how it works. So let us just make it like a matte floor with like, let us see what's gonna work. Okay. Let's quickly see a render preview and see how it looks. So we have this. Fergie says, "Ooh, pretty." I don't know what you're saying this for, but I'm assuming it's for the painting. Oh, that's too much light. That is too much light. Let me just quickly stop this render and go to my environment. So this is where the good part comes in, guys. So if you do not want a daylight scene and you want like a night scene to make it like look more like intimate, what you do is you go to the environment, you click on environment light, and instead of decrease like turning it off, you can decrease the intensity of the light and see how it looks. You can also turn it off, but then you gotta have like a lot of light sources to make it look good. These light sources are too overpowering right now, and that is why this is looking like it's emitting too much light, right? So let's quickly click on this object. Go to the. Hold on, let me just save my file. I think it's gonna die soon. Yep. Let's click on this object. This is cylinder 2. I'm gonna rename them later on. That's not something to worry about. Here you see the glow option and you can decrease it, right? So you click on this. I just select 300 and see what it looks like. Maybe even lesser than that, 264. Let's just go back to this. I will decrease this glow as well. I will make it to 250 just to be sure. I'll make it to 250 again. So again, these are the kind of things that you can just experiment with, and once you know what you're doing and once you see how much intensity you've decreased for the environment, that's when you can figure out how much light you actually need. And yeah, there you go. I will see how it looks on the render preview. Let us see over here. Still too much light. Still too much light. So, actually, let's see now because you're not gonna see the lights later on, right? So let's just see the render preview and see how it looks like. This is interesting. But we're definitely not gonna know until we finally render the image, which is definitely gonna take some time. But let's see if we can do that on stream and then like add some vignetting on in Photoshop and make it look more contemporary. And yeah, I think it looks good, right? What do you guys think? This is the top angle, this is the right hand side. It's gonna take some time because there are a lot of objects out here, but yeah, I'm just getting a notification on my phone about like a pizza place sending me advertisements, and I'm definitely hungry now. Wine and pizza is like the best combination. Sorry for all the wine connoisseurs out there. I like how you do the lights. I need to try that. Oh, thanks, Fergie. Yeah, it's super simple, right? It's just like glowing object on whatever glowing material and whatever object you want. It's super simple. I think this light is a little bit too harsh right now, so I'm gonna click on that. Cylinder 2. Click on the properties, and I think I'm gonna make it 200. This should do the trick. Let's save it really quick and render it out. I can't believe I did all of this in like an hour. Pretty cool. I'm getting better with this. I like it. Okay, let's quickly see how the other angles look like. Let's see what the top angle looks like. So again, my canvas size is like 1400 by 768. 768 is the default. It comes by 1024 by 768 pixels. I usually make it 1400 and not change the 768 because this is already too big of a canvas for me to work on. I don't have that big of a screen to actually concentrate on everything. It does zoom out, but it's too much to deal with. Anyway, I think this also should decrease a little. So this is what happens when you render preview, guys. Whatever things that you don't like, you can see how it's going to look like after the render and you can adjust it. I'm going to actually decrease it to 100. And for this as well. Let's see where it is. I think just quickly paused it, did I? Yeah, I did. Okay, here it is. We have 100. And now I'm gonna save it really quick. Command S. And it's like when you lose your work once, you always like you never forget to save it. Okay. We have, I think I'm gonna decrease it a little bit more. This is supposed to be like a candle, right? So this is like too much right now. Let's quickly decrease this to like, let's say 30. Let's see. Oh yeah, now it's gonna do it. This is gonna take, this is definitely gonna do it. Let's see. Make it 30. Definitely. Huge difference from what it was at. It was at 500. So since this is at like 30, this is definitely doing some help to the scene. Okay, awesome. So this is like a very, you know, artsy fartsy thing to do. Like have this knife coming out of the cutting board. There's this grape spilled out. There's some blueberries. There's crackers. So this is like one simple scene creation. And I really like 3D and like still life. And I've been a fan of 3D for like a few weeks now. That is all I can say, but it is panning out really, really nicely. There's a right. So let's just see how this angle looks like and how the lamp looks like. I'm just experimenting now to see how the final render is going to look like before I actually go and render it, because rendering sometimes takes like 10 to 20 minutes or even 30 to 40 minutes, depending on what quality of file you have, like the image, and also how many objects you have, and also your machine capabilities. But yeah, it's always good to see and have a double check of what's going on. There is a spill zoom as well. Wow, I love this scene. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna create a new scene and I'm gonna quickly show you one another trick, which is probably going to be my last trick. And if you can see this camera button right there, okay, hold on. I'm gonna come out of the camera render preview. I click on the camera button, I'm already in this angle. I'm gonna command save it before something happens. I feel like something's gonna go wrong really soon. I hope not. But I click on the camera and you can see all these camera properties, right? So there's a camera perspective. You have a field of view. It's set to 45, but I can zoom in and out to like just how I do it with the mouse. I can do it with this slider over here and I can also change the positions. I don't want to change that, but I do want to put like a focus. So I'm gonna set a focus point to the wine. The spilled wine, and I go to camera again, and I can decrease or increase the blur amount. So let's say I set it to 63%. It is too much. 63.1, it's too much, right? Let's just decrease it a little to like 4.9. Yeah, I think 5 or 4.9 should like do the trick. Let's just leave it and create a new camera angle. So you retain the older one, right? You bookmark this and you rename it spill zoom focus. Okay, and now let's render it and see how it's gonna look. There you go, much better. It's like we're only focusing on the spill right now because the evening's already spoiled. Oh, I heard Derek was going to party. Maybe you can get some wine this weekend, Derek. I hope you do. Okay, getting back. U8, there is U8, there is angled left. These look kind of similar, so I might not render all of them. But there's a spill zoom that I did. Maybe I can like do a perspective shot of this as well, so I can focus on the bread. I think I'll rotate this a little, zoom in a little. Press 1, 2, and 3. That's all the keys I use on the keyboard. 1 to orbit, 2 to pan, and 3 to zoom. So this is something that I want to focus on. So I just click on my camera again. I'm saving it in between with every click that I do. We have the camera. We click on focus, and my focus is gonna be the bread. So that's cool. Let's see what happens. Actually, let's move it a little. Hold on, what just happened? Oh no, I double clicked on it. You go to camera, I'm sorry. Yeah. Okay, cool. I think this looks good. So you can see there's light in the background. I'm gonna remove that by just, but I want the spill. So let's change the camera angle a little. Press one and then press two again. Right? You make a new camera bookmark, you click on this, and you rename it bread zoom focus. Okay, awesome. I'm gonna try and render this really quickly and just see how much time it's gonna take. But if it's taking too long, I'm just gonna upload it to my Behance and you guys can all check it out over there. So if you have any questions for me, you can drop them in the chat and I will be happy to answer them. If you have any queries about my process, if you want to know something I did and you missed it, or anything like that, just let me know in the chat and I'll be happy to answer. Let us quickly log these while you guys catch up in the chat. I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna see what scene these are. There's top, there is right, there is spill zoom. So I'm gonna quickly render out home view 8. So let's say this angle is like this is like this. I'm gonna quickly just this is view 8, right? So if I press this button, it's gonna rename, recreate the view, but I won't have to actually physically go and rename everything. Okay, awesome. So yeah, let's see how much time it's gonna take. Let's click on render. If it's just 5 minutes, I can probably stay in and see how it's looking. We click on view 8, spill zoom and bread focus. I am gonna create PSDs. Change the location. This is something that I was working on earlier. I can just go to art. I can go to 3D objects. I can go to Behance. I can go to renders. Open and render. Awesome. It was great to be here today, guys. So I think I'm gonna make it like a weekly thing. And probably gonna be streaming like earlier in the day for me, so it's like night time where from where most people tune in. And yeah, I think that's what's gonna help the whole stream and the whole process. And if you guys are new and you don't know me, there is my information on the screen down below. There is Twitter, there is YouTube, there is Behance, there is Instagram, and also my website. So feel free to check my work out. Let me know what you think. And there's also my social media links in the bio. There is 3D models and 3D materials link. That's actually where I got my materials and textures from. So you can check it out if you like it. Definitely go ahead and check it out. And there's a lot of free stuff. You just have to sign up. And I swear they don't sell your information anywhere. So like, don't be afraid to sign up. And if you like the music, there's like a free playlist by Harris Heller. It's on Spotify. It's also on my link. I'll always like to like quote back to whatever free things I'm using because they're also creators like us, and I really like to credit everyone. So yeah, I think that's it for today, but I'm just waiting for this render to come out and it says 20 minutes. This is definitely not happening today. So I think you can see some of it coming to shape. It is coming to shape and coming to life. So we're gonna leave it at this. And Yep, I actually thought I could like Photoshop it and show you how I make a contemporary scene out of it, but I'm just gonna tell you what I'm gonna do. So once it's done, it still says 19 minutes, but I'm gonna do it later on. So once it's done, what you do is go to Photoshop and you go to create like make this whole thing as a smart object, group all the layers with the depth and the shadows and the background, everything that rendered out, just make it to a group and convert it to a smart object. And then what you do is go to filters. I think it's filters in the navigation on the top navigation bar. You go to filter, you go to camera raw filter, and you can adjust everything out there. What I would do to create a contemporary scene would be to add some grain on top, some vignetting on the sides, and also maybe adjust the warmth a little bit to give it like that contemporary feel and look. So I think that's it for today, guys. I am so glad you had the time to join me today and learn about Adobe Dimension. And again, if you have any questions for me, just drop it to me via DM on Instagram or Behance, anything. I'm available. And let me know what you thought of it. And don't forget to appreciate the stream if you liked it. It's gonna help me heaps. And yep, I hope you enjoyed and see you next time. See you next week, guys. Bye-bye. Have a good weekend.